So, hello and welcome. Some of you asked for a short little team report of the team I used in the Players Cup Global Finals and on the channel for the first week of 2-4 Champion. And I won't do like a PowerPoint team report since the team didn't do as well as I hoped for. I mean, the team, it wasn't a team fault, it was more based on Hex and Wolf for playing me a bit, but the first one was definitely me getting hexed extremely hard. So it's definitely not a team error, and I think the team performed on ladder and as well on the tournament pretty well overall. And yeah, this is the final version. I will talk about the team, but first I will talk about my team building process in general. So first I thought, okay, Sunroom seems pretty good. I want to test with Sunroom. So I started building. I knew I needed Torkoal or Venusaur, and I thought, okay, back in Series 5 people use Tyranitar on Sunroom. I never liked that because Tyranitar doesn't give you like a rock resist, it doesn't set Trick Room itself, it battles with Torkoal for the weather and stuff like that. I didn't like that. So with the introduction of Zakataka, I was like, okay, that's basically solving all the problems I had with Tyranitar. It's a very slow Trick Room sweeper, it's a rock type, which Sun really loves because of flying types. It's a rock resistance, and it can set up Trick Room itself. So I was like, okay, I definitely want Zakataka. Then I knew that I wanted Redirection, because I personally don't like Trick Rooms where I rely on Trick Room but cannot secure it going up. For example, with my Players Cup 2 qualifier team, I had Porygon and no Redirection, but Porygon is so bulky, and Porygon also, like, I did not have a Trick Room mode that was my main game plan. Porygon was mainly Trick Room one that offers some control, but with Sunroom you sometimes definitely want Trick Room up 100%, and then you, in my opinion, need Redirection. So I was, okay, I want Ndidi or I want Clefairy. I tested Clefairy and it was pretty decent, but overall I thought Ndidi would be a little bit better to give me the psychic terrain to be able to sleepwalk. At some point I had sleepwalker onto the Sinusio, and yet I dropped it because Protect seems a little better for me. And yeah, and then I for some reason added Feeny and Voltres, and basically I just tested some stuff and the team didn't work as well as I hoped for. So I made a new edition. As you see, I had Torkoal, Venusaur, Zakataka every time, because I think these are the best. I changed Zakataka to Life Orb since Cobberry seemed pretty good to me in while testing, being able to Dynamax fairly safe versus flying types. On this version I have Sleepwalker. I'm still not really sure what I like more. I think overall Protect is better, but Sleepwalker was mainly for pressuring in team preview, I would guess. Yeah, then I added Lumberry Thunders for the Mirror match. Lumberry Thunders is just really strong versus Sun overall. Urshifu was mainly in the team to deal with stuff like Dusclops and opposing Zakataka. And yeah, Clefairy, I figured out that Zakataka and Didi was a little bit too weak versus Urshifu, so I added Clefairy for that. Yeah, that went way better for me. But still, I felt like I was most times only bringing the Trick Room mode and not the other stuff. So I wasn't confident to bring this. And then I figured out, okay, let's test some Ranger codes of some teams and see what I could like. I saw this Porygon team and tested it, and practice it was really well, although Porygon had ally switch, which I hated and I never clicked it. So I thought, like, okay, let's try my own Porygon, my offensive Porygon, which I used in the Players Cup qualifier. And yeah, put on Feeny, because Feeny is very well with Regirock. I added Regirock over Sakataka. I'm not really sure why I did that in the end. Maybe I thought like Porygon is such a good trick move that I don't need Sakataka anymore. And yeah, on this team you can see I don't have redirection because the main mode was Torkoal Venusaur and Porygon like Landorus or stuff like that. So with Porygon, as I said, you don't need as much of redirection, especially since only like close combat can hit it for super much damage and I haven't intimidated. And so with Landorus was also pretty good onto some teams. And yeah, with this team, the only major problem I had was mirrors. Mirrors were like, they were kinda stupid in my opinion, so I didn't like that. And overall, Sun didn't fit my playstyle too much, so yeah. What I got from testing this team was that Regirock, in my opinion, is really strong, so I decided, hey, Regirock is a very good Pokemon with Dynamax. It's very decent versus Sun, especially with Feeny. It cannot be intimidated, so it's really strong versus Incineroar stuff as well. It has Ice Punch for Landorus, and I just wanted to use Regirock for some reason. I figured it was really cool, really fun, and also really strong. And I was like, okay, nobody will really like prepare for Regirock. So maybe we can take the crown by bringing a Pokemon that nobody expects. Yeah, this was the first version. I knew that I wanted Regirock to be this fast because with this amount of speed I outspeed like Landorus when I'm at plus 2 or Landorus which has minus 2. So this was the benchmark I wanted to hit. 236 attack because it's enough for the bump. I will go into some calculations later on. I had Lumberlandus for the Sun matchup. Leftovers Feeny, I will go into the spread later on because it's the same spread I used in the final version. Same for Katana. Third best because like no other set really works for me, so yeah, I always value the third best onto Katana. Safety Goggles Rotom for the Sun matchup. And Light Clay Crimson. I put Swagger onto this mainly because since I had Lumber on Landorus, Swagger is a really good combination when I'm not playing versus Sun to double the attack set of my Landorus, which I thought would be really good. Also, there are some situations where the Misty Terrain is set up and I can Swagger my Katana and my Regirock. That's the reason why I had Swagger on this. In the end, this team was really good, but I felt like, okay, I could make some minor changes and maybe it would be better. I figured out that Lumberry and Landorus wasn't really as needed because most times I would bring Rotom for the Sun anyways because of Class 3A. So I figured, okay, what item could I bring on Landorus? And I was like, okay, why not test like Life Orb? And then I don't really need a Swagger onto Crimson either. I also had some issues with speed control. So I figured, okay, what move could I give Grimmsnarl, or what move could I add in general to getting more speed control? And I figured, okay, Scary Face on Grimmsnarl seems pretty decent, especially with Regirock, and nobody will expect Regirock to outspeed Landorus when it's got hit by Scary Face. And I figured, okay, that would be pretty decent. So yeah, that's how the final version came together. This spread. Basically, it's maximum bulk, maximum offense. As I said, the speed is towards speed Adamant Landorus after Scary Face. And yeah, the attack gives me the extra point from Adamant, as well as Okoing Incineroar, 252, 76 defense Incineroar with Max Rockfall, because you cannot intimidate me. And I wanted KO Tapu Fini, like 252, 20 defense. Tapu Fini with plus 2 Max Rockfall, which in my opinion was really, really strong. And Max Hailstorm Oko's Landorus. So yeah, that's the spread I liked. I considered like dropping a bit attack for some special defense, but Retrog only has 100 base attack. It's really not as high, so you really want to have as much offense as possible, and since the HP base is way lower than the defensive stats, I was pretty much forced to max the HP base. I ran Curse over something like Protect or High Horsepower, because like Curse gives me max guard, which is pretty valuable in some situations, as well as like Retrovoke was somehow my trick room counter, and for example the opponent leads, let's say, Dusclops Grimmsnarl or Dusclops Faker user or Clefairy stuff, something like that. I can just curse up and become slower, not slower than the trick room mons of course, but slower than some mons, and I also gain more attack, I gain even more defense. Like Retrovoke after one curse just takes no damage from any physical attack, and yeah, that's why I want curse over like Protect, because curse has some situations where it's pretty good. I mean, Protect can also be really really good, but being able to protect trick room teams was way more valuable in my opinion. Rock Slide is obvious. Ice Punch is in my opinion necessary for Landorus. And then the last stat was between Drain Punch, Super Power and like High Horsepower. And Body Press was Body Press over Super Power was the idea. Body Press is really strong on the Retrovoke, especially with Curse. And you can also raise your attack with Max Knuckle and stuff like that. Overall, I thought Drain Punch could be a little bit better, mainly to like in the end game, if I curse up, for example, versus Polygon or stuff like that, I can just Drain Punch to recover basically all of my health, and then Retrovoke should be really hard to deal with. That was the idea. High Horsepower was consideration mainly for being able to boost my special defense. But since Retrovoke has such a low attack, I valued the option to go for Max Knuckle a bit more. And yeah, like 100 base special defense is still very good, and with Sand Up it's definitely not bad, so I figured I don't need the ground coverage. Also, if I really want the special defense boost, I can also just Dynamax Landorus. Yeah, there's nothing more to say about it, I think. What you have to know is that this Retrovoke, when Dynamax, like, gets 3 KO'd by close combat from Urshifu, which is crazy. I mean, really wrong. No, it's not even a 3 KO. Let me check my cacs real quick. Let's see. Defensive benchmarks. Yeah, you can see really doesn't take any damage from Max Quirk from Landorus, and it's hilarious. Yeah, tries Vex Tabufini can KO you, but it's not guaranteed by any means. Where's the card? I mean, here, look at this. Just coming from Earth for a regular Retrovoke, like with Reflect being up, you can chill. You can chill all day. That's really cool. Yeah, here, that was the card I meant. Choice Band onto Dynamax. Reflect and Curse basically the same. So yeah, that's really, really strong. And here, Choice Band, Single Strike, Choice Band, Rapid Strike, most times does not 2-hit KO you when you Dynamax, which is also really good. Okay. Yeah, that's basically Retrovoke. I feel like Retrovoke is really, really cool, really strong, and definitely underrated. Let's go over Landorus. So, you can see I changed the spread. The first Landorus was only evied to outspeed like Timid Venusaur, which I figured was still a consideration, and I wanted to make sure that like I outspeed Venusaur after I scary faced it for sure. After I changed the Landorus to Life Orb, I was like, okay, I may want to go max speed, mainly to guarantee that I outspeed everything. Like, also base 90s like Moltres, which can give this team fair bit of trouble if not played correctly. So I figured, okay, Landorus, let's go max speed if you go life up. And then I was okay, some bulk could be great, and I like to go to like 10x, 10n, minus 1 when I'm EVing my HP with life up. This means 10n means 10 times the number. So in this case, 17n is 170 HP, minus 1 is 169 HP, and that was my goal. So I added 36 EVs into HP, and then like I usually do 4 into both defenses to maximize my value I get from the EVs. And this came into play, for example, versus Wolfie, versus Colossal in game 2, where I survived just barely, and I think the bulk mattered in this case. And yeah, I did some kayaks and the attack really didn't change much. I maybe could have dropped some attack as well, but all I could have done is putting it into defenses, and I figured if I go live up, I want to go as offensive as possible. Yeah, move wise, pretty self-explanatory. I thought a bit about running sword stance, but since I don't have any reaction and no fake out, I dropped that idea really quick. In the end, Protect was really good. Tap Fini. At some points I had Citrus Berry, but since I have screen support and overall Tap Fini stays in the field way longer than most spawns, and I also have Protect, Leftovers was the right choice in my opinion. Over time it recovers way more than any berry could. I went the Calm Mindset. At first I wanted to use my old favorite Icy Wind, Heal Pull, Swagger type of Fini, but then I figured out Fini does not learn Swagger, so that was not an option, so I had to go for an offensive, more offensive version. In terms of IVs, max HP is pretty much always the case on type of Fini. Sometimes you run 175 to take less damage from sand, but since I run Leftovers, the goal was obviously 176 to get one more point from recovery, and since the HP is very low compared to the rest of the defensive stats, I maxed the HP. The next benchmark I had for speed, I wanted to outspeed like Thunderous stuff at plus 1, and also most other Finis that aim to achieve that. You need 120, like 120 as a stat to outspeed base 111 like Thunderous at plus 1. So I figured, okay, just go 1 point faster and you will outspeed most Finis, which came into play sometimes. Then I put like the rest into special attack because I wanted to get the extra point from Modest. At some point I had Calm and stuff like that, but like Calm was fine back in VGC 17 and 18. There I had really defensive Calm Mind type of Finis, but in this season I felt like I tried that set, but it felt a little bit too passive sometimes, so I figured, okay, I just want to go a little bit more offensive. Yeah, then there's not much else to say. 12 special defense to get one more point from the boost, and I think it also meant that I survived something which I otherwise wouldn't guaranteed survive, but I'm not remembering anymore. And yeah, I tried to achieve that I guaranteed live Katana Leaf Blade when it's invested, but that took a little bit too much of defensive investment, and with this I still take Leaf Blade from most assault with katanas if they don't crit, and I think that was okay, since most times I would not face Katana anyway with Fini, and I have screens up anyways, and if it's crit, it's a kill regardless of what I do, so there was not much point in EVing specifically for that, in my opinion. Speaking of Katana, here's my own Katana. Like I said, I love Assault Vest. Focus Touch is another good item, but I just value having every coverage I can. And I like to Dynamax Katana. Focus Touch is a really bad item when you Dynamax, then you basically have no items, so yeah, Assault Vest is for me most times the way to go. Life Up is another option, but I never like Life Up Katana. Expert. Pat Belt or stuff like that. Back then I liked Zimuf Katana, especially McSnuckle. Not McSnuckle. All of Pummeling or whatever it was called, the Z fighting move. And I liked Z Tailwind, but those are no options anymore. Katana doesn't even learn Tailwind anymore. Yeah, move wise, very standard. Not much to say about. I need every move. Like, some people drop Aerial Ace for like Night Slash, and I would consider knockoff if Katana could learn knockoff. But since it doesn't learn it, Aerial Ace is the way to go for me to potentially boost my speed if I really want to or really need to. And on the meta testing, Aerial Ace came into clutch at some points. At first sense I had like only 200 and I think 4 invested. No, 228 to outspeed like Timid Nihiligo, which in my opinion was a benchmark. I wanted to hit for sure. Some people only go 168 to outspeed base 100, but I wanted to make sure that I outspeed Nihiligo as well. Since I have 3 Pokemon that get threatened by it really hard, I wanted my Katana to kill it before it can do anything. And then I figured, okay, I don't want to like have awkward mind games with opposing katanas if they are even faster. And then I was like, okay, let's just go max speed, and then at worst it's a speed tie versus other surface katana, but most times I will outspeed because not much people go max speed, I think. And then I put just everything into special defense, because with Katana you see how low the special defense is. You need to invest as much as possible and equip the surface to take some specials decent. And then I put the rest into like 4-4-4, because it's the optimal way to EV in that situation, because the only other option I had was doing something like this, and that's really not very efficient. So that's the most efficient you can go. I did some calcs. A little bit more attack could help in some situations, but overall it didn't really matter. And I only like could drop this much, about this much anyways, and 28 compared to 4 when you have 181 base doesn't really make any difference, but the speed makes it different in many situations. So I figured that would be way more valuable. Yeah, Rotom Heat. Safety Goggles is by far my favorite item on Rotom. Like, Citrus Wave is also good, but most times Rotom Heat is my main Glass Ray Sun counter. So I really need Safety Goggles, because like, Sleep Pod is just stupid. So you have to have a switch in for that. Nasty Plot Protect Thunderbolt Overheat is my preferred set. I don't like running something like Dark Pulse over Nasty Plot or Protect, so I will most times run this set. In terms of speed, you see I ran a bit of a faster Rotom. Reason for that was I wanted to outspeed like Timid Lapras, because in the Victory Road tournament I got crushed by Timid Lapras and really screwed me over, and I wanted to make sure that I outspeed it in case I randomly run into it. You never know. And I had some EVs leftovers anyway, so I figured that would be a good option. Also, this make sure that I outspeed like every Tapu Fini. There's no way any Tapu Fini is even faster than this, so I felt very confident with that amount of speed. 116 special deck, like always, I want to hit the bump to get extra point from the nature, and then just maximum HP. Since HP base is really low, I could have done like this, which would also be a good option since HP is that low, but I like to have 4-4 into both stats if possible, and that's why I did that. Yeah, nothing else to say about it. I don't have any specific like calc in my mind. I didn't calc very much for most of these ones, because I'm very familiar with what they do, with how much damage they take from attacks. I was just like, okay, let's hit the speed marks I want to, and it was more about deciding which moves what one could get, which item I want to run to which one, and in general, like, how to play the team, and not specifically Kaiken for something, because I'm very familiar with all of these mons except Retorog. And last member was Grimmsnarl. I don't know the order I put them on together. I think Retorog was first, then Tabuffini, then Katana, then I think Rotom. I think Grimmsnarl was really the last one I added, because I was like, okay, I really have a somehow bulky team. Why not make it even more bulky? And I always like Grimmsnarl for its ability to get up screens really, really reliable and like have good control over the field while also having good damage output. And yeah, Grimmsnarl is really cool. Light Screen Reflect, obviously. Spirit Break for Urshifu and to lower special attacks even further. And as I said, I dropped Swagger for Scary Face to have like reliable speed control. I only had like 2 max airstreams so far, which I only can use one at best in the match. So Scary Face was a really good option, in my opinion. The other option was like Thunder Wave, but the problem with Thunder Wave is it can miss, and it does not affect electric and like ground types, and also dark types. It's the same for Scary Face in that case, because you cannot prank the dark type mons, but that was a major downside for me. Also the chance of missing, I don't like that at all. So yeah, also you can like Scary Face multiple times, and you can sometimes Scary Face your own mon in Trick Room to make it slower. And also Thunder Wave is really bad with Tapofini, so overall Thunder Wave was never a real consideration on this slot. It was always Scary Face or Swagger. I put 12 Beat Eevees into this to make sure that I outspeed most opposing Grimmsnarls, and I also outspeed, I hit 160 with this, right? Yeah, so I definitely outspeed like Urshifus when I'm at +2, for example, which is unlikely, but it can happen. And that was not the main goal. The main goal was to outspeed opposing Grimmsnarls, because I don't like running like this and then it's a speed tie at best, and that's not cool in my opinion. 4 is also not that good, because sometimes people have 4 leftovers and then it's the speed tie as well. And I figured some people could go 12 as well, but same point. I didn't expect to face too many Grimmsnarls, and I was willing to take the risk that they also won 12 EVs. Maximum HP, because overall bulk, 4 into attack to just put the leftovers I had into that. And then I decided to go plus special defense nature, because special defense is a bit higher, so I get more value out of the nature. And decided to like make both defenses like pretty similar, with the idea of having one more point in special defense, so Porygon 2 gets the attack boost when facing Grimmsnarl, which is always a thing I have in my mind. And yeah, that's basically the spread. There's no specific calculation I did, to be honest, because I won Grimmsnarl like this for like nearly a year now, and it's always really good. Yeah, that's the team. Nothing more to say for me. If you want to see how the team plays, just watch the first 5 episodes of True for Champion. I will link them in the description. And yeah, as always, thanks for watching. Please leave a like, comment and subscribe, and try the team out yourself. I will link the PokePaste and the rental code in the description as well. Yeah, have a good one, stay healthy, thanks.